Okay, it's recording. Start.
Today I'm going to present a case on Budkerry syndrome. So first, what is this Budkerry syndrome? As we can see here, in the liver there are so many veins like portal veins, central veins, hepatic veins. So basically in this Budkerry syndrome, the hepatic veins through oxygenated heart will, so the fluid content will remain back in the liver itself. It won't reach the heart. So what happens here, as the fluid contains remains back in the liver, that won't reach the heart. So the heart will increase its pressure to get that blood. So what happens, as the pressure increases, the BP will increase. Therefore, for this patient, only the diastolic blood pressure is increased. And the patient was not an alcoholic. Okay. So this is how the Budkerry syndrome patient abdominal looks like. This fluid, I mean, due to the increased pressure on heart, the albumin content in the blood, that will comes out into the blood vessel, into the peritoneal cavity, and thereby the fluid will increase in this peritoneal cavity, which is called ascites. Got it, no? I think it is. So,
your voice is breaking, man.
Sir, I'll start from again. I'll start again.
No. Now your voice is clear. Continue.
Okay, sir. My patient is having chief complaints of abdominal distensing and pain since 20 days. And he had a past medical history of gastritis once in 15 days. In the provisional diagnosis, they were suspect the patient to have Budkerry syndrome. Like this, the serum protein is more than 1.1 gram per deciliter in this patient. Like it is almost 3.3. Yeah, here you can see 3.3 gram per deciliter. This condition happens only in the sclerosis or alcoholic hepatitis of Budkerry syndrome. Since the patient is not an alcoholic, we can confirm the diagnosis. We can confirm the patient to have a Budkerry syndrome. This is the lab values. As you can see, the serum albumin level is less because the albumin content in the serum will move into the blood vessels. It moves out of the blood vessels. Medication, they have given ondansetron, which is antiemetic, and they have given the pantoprazole. They have given ceftriaxone antibiotic. They have given hepatic protectant and the nutritional supplement to the patient. So these are the subjective and objective evidence. Based on these evidences, the patient can be diagnosed to have Budkerry syndrome. Our goals: to reduce the signs and symptoms, to prevent the progressive of liver damage, to prevent the further complication, to reduce the hospitalization period. Treatment option, we can give the patient thrombolytics and we can also give diuretics since the fluid is more in the body. We can give diuretics to excrete it out. We can give percutaneous transluminal angioplasty. We can do transjugular intrahepatic portal systemic shunting, that is through the jugular vein. We can, and in the most worst case, we can do the liver transplantation also. Here the pharmacist intervention is like they have given citrate. They have suspected the patient to have infection, and they have given citrate for the in the first day, but they didn't continue for the next. I mean, they didn't complete the course of antibiotic. They have given only for one day. That I found as a pharmacist intervention. And patient counseling, we have to explain about his medical condition and about the drug. Ondansetron, it increases the, it causes the QT prolongation. So it can cause arrhythmia. So we have to report any arrhythmia, change of heart rate, or any headache is there in the patient. We have to report it back. Citrate, we have to report the severe diarrhea. For PAN, we have to report hypomagnesemia, vitamins with prolongation of PPI. Hypomagnesemia happens only with prolonged use of PPI, not in the short term use of PPI. Usually, we have to take with food, and Heptrel, we have to take in the empty stomach. Since the Heptrel is an entry coated tablet, if we take with the food, it might block the absorption of the drug. So we have to take in the empty stomach, and we have to report the sign of depression. And lifestyle modification for this patient is they have to quit smoking, manage their weight, restrict protein intake, they have to reduce the salt intake, they have to stick to medication adherence. And regular health checkup should be there. Thank you. Any doubts in this?
Somewhere you had written SCAAG something. I didn't get that.
Sorry, SCAAG? Yeah, I'll explain you. I think it's here, yeah. Just give me a minute. Oh. SAAG is nothing but serum ascites albumin gradient. It is nothing but the serum albumin, like how much amount of albumin present in the serum. Got no? You can see here one more. Wait. Yeah, in this you can see the protein level. Is 3.3 gram per deciliter. SAAG is nothing but serum ascites albumin gradient.
And then should we consider this patient as hepatic impaired? Should we adjust the doses of drug which it eliminated to liver? Should we consider this patient as hepatic impaired?
Sorry. Can you repeat again?
Should we consider this patient as hepatic impaired? Should we adjust the doses, I mean?
No need to adjust any dose. Like it is an hepatic impaired only, but we don't have to adjust any dose. Like it is not so much severe. We can give the whatever the normal dose is there. We can give that the same dose here.
What that is the final diagnosis only. But carry was the final diagnosis.
Yeah. It is the final diagnosis.
Because there you had written a provisional diagnosis.
Yeah, but again I have confirmed with a wait. Again I have confirmed with a provisional and here. Subjective and objective evidence have assisted the patient to have a Budkerry syndrome due to a high SSAG protein.
Ultrasound was not done for this patient because they do ultrasound, no? This is a veno occlusive, like it occludes the veins of the liver.
Yeah.
So you can see that inflammation of that veins on the, it will be seen actually. So I thought.
Sorry? No, they haven't done
veins
that.
Will be veins will be occluded, so it will be inflamed actually. The veins you can see on the stomach. The stomach part you can see the veins actually.
Yeah.
Was any biopsy done? to no, see no. the liver echo texture also?
Biopsy I have not done. There's only one test they have done, that is ascites fluid analysis. They'll take the fluid which is there in this abdominal through the injection on needle. They'll just drag that fluid, and they'll check it. What and all the content is there. In that, the protein content was more. So we can tell according to that. We can tell that the protein content is more in the peritoneal cavity, like that is a fluid, and we can confirm that the serum albumin level is less.
I didn't see any diuretic in the medication pack. Was it there?
Yeah, no. That's why I kept in a drug of choice. Diuretics have not given. That's why I've given in the. I kept in the drug of choice.
And that could be a clinical pharmacy intervention.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
This is a real case, huh?
Yes, sir.
Where you have taken this case?
It's a Baptist only, sir. I have taken like March 10th, around that, like that time I took, sir. March 2nd.
It's also an internet case.
No, sir. Yeah. Not internet case.
You see the picture. The picture is.
So, what might be the etiology for this patient, sir?
Sorry.
Like, what might be the etiology for this patient, Budkerry syndrome? Any particular cause?
As I told you, the hepatic veins. These hepatic veins will block. Except that.
For this patient, was there any particular cause or something?
No. There is no particular cause or anything else.
And that is why I asked about this ultrasound. Also, if they have done the ultrasound, they can see in the clot. So that is why they can give the thrombolytics.
They don't have to do abdominal because they have done this. Wait, I'll show you. Because they have done this ascites fluid analysis. In that fluid, you can tell, like, you can see the albumin content is more. So by that, you can confirm. Like, in that also, three chances will be there, like cirrhosis, alcoholic hepatitis, and Budkerry syndrome. But for this patient, since he is not an alcoholic, it won't. We can't tell that he have a cirrhosis or an alcoholic hepatitis. So we can confirm the patient to have a Budkerry syndrome.
And this Budkerry is a very rare disorder. You won't find it so common, and that is why I had a doubt, like whether his veins are occluded.
Since it is a very rare condition, that's why I have selected this topic.
No, just by ascites.
Sorry.
Thrombosis is the main cause.
Yeah, thrombosis is there.
For thrombosis, yeah, also there's no.
See, this can happen in liver malignancy also.
There's no particular like test which can rule out other conditions. This ascites fluid analysis cannot rule out other conditions. No? There should be
confirmed diagnosis actually.
Sorry?
Any anticoagulant therapy given?
No anticoagulant therapy is given.
What about albumin?
Sorry, your voice is so low. No, sorry, your voice is so low.
What about albumin? Albumin therapy?
Yeah, albumin therapy they have done. They have found it like albumin is.
What is that?
They've done like albumin is more in the serum. I mean, in the peritoneal cavity, that moves because of the pressure, the albumin content in the blood, that albumin content will move out of the blood vessel into the peritoneal cavity. So,
like what changes? Hello? What changes can we see in what differentiate like what all changes can be differentiated between a patient with cirrhosis and this condition? Like, are there any specific like differences? Because
specific,
even a cirrhosis patient also will have this specific
arthritis. But the cirrhosis patient, they have to be an alcoholic. They have to be, the patient have to be an alcoholic for a cirrhosis patient, but this patient need not have to be. Like, this patient won't be an alcoholic.
But so, still, there is a possibility of liver malignancy, no?
Yeah, but
in
they
case
have
of liver malignancy also, there's a possibility of this ascites, all this. You can't rule out, like, malignancy.
Just by aseptic fluid analysis, we can't rule out other diseases. I think some
should have been. Okay.
And once again, what are the presenting complaints?
Presenting complaints, the progressive of abdominal distensing and the pain since 20 days. And the past medical history, he had gastritis once in 15 days.
Go to the current medication.
Just the inflammation also, there is no fever or nothing like that, no?
Sorry? No fever.
Fever or any other signs of inflammation for the patient?
No fever or anything else. Sir,
neutrophils was like around 80%. What is the total count of WBC? So that
you
can assess to what extent. In ascitic fluid tapping, you said neutrophil percentage is 80%.
Okay. I didn't say that.
Total count of
What is the?
Neutrophils 80% is due to. What is the total WBC count so that we can at least know what is it's an inflammation or not?
Actually, the WBC count was more actually, but I didn't check properly. I have forgot, like I have collected so long back.
Can this cause hepatic encephalopathy or coagulopathy like in cirrhosis?
Sorry?
Can this condition cause hepatic encephalopathy or coagulopathy as we see in cirrhosis patients or on liver disease?
No, it won't cause anything.
Is there any particular reason why it doesn't cause?
I'll check and I'll tell you, but it won't cause. I have checked it. What is the difference between cirrhosis? They have clearly mentioned that nothing will be there like that, but I'll check the reason why behind it and I'll let you know. Sir, you have asked for the medication chart.
Where is the liver enzymes, ma'am? Liver enzymes, bilirubin, all they have to do, no? Why the ursodiol?
Sir, it is there.
Used.
Direct bilirubin is there, AST, ALT.
Next slide. Medications. Why ursodiolic acid is given?
Sir, it is an hepatoprotecting, sir. Since the patient is having a problem with the liver, they have given this.
If this disease is caused by clots, why no anticoagulant is given?
Yeah, they have not given anticoagulant. That's why I have put it in the treatment option. But I didn't keep it in the pharmacist intervention. I should have kept it in the pharmacist intervention.
Then how they managed ascites? Without diuretics also not given.
Sir, like I have collected this case for 2 days. Maybe after the second day they would have given, sir. But I have followed it only for 1 day.
No, at the time of presentation only, FSH is that they'll start, like, most probably they'll start with diuretics.
Sorry, it is not audible.
At the time of presentation only, if they find like ascites and stuff, they'll more likely start diuretics.
They haven't start any diuretics because this was the first day presentation. I mean, first day medication chart. This one was the first day medication chart. When I went in there, next day also it was the same. Then after that, when I go through the case, then only I came to know that we could have given that. First day they have suspected the patient to have infection, that's why they have given ceftriaxone, and the next day they haven't given.
Dose of ceftriaxone.
Ceftriaxone dose is this case 1 gram for 50 ml. Sorry? Hello?
This case is from our hospital, BBH.
Yeah.
This case you collected Baptist. In BBH only, no?
Yeah.
Okay, like ceftriaxone brand, what is that? Ceftriaxone brand name, I never saw that, I guess. I don't recall.
Brand name I didn't check, like generic name only I written.
And this ceftriaxone causes liver sludge. I mean, the biliary sludge actually. So I think they won't give in the.
They have given for the first day. Like they are suspected.
There's some antibiotics to be avoided.
They have to avoid. But what happened is, first day the patient came with the complaints of abdominal distensing and pain, no? So what they have suspected is, they have suspected the patient to have an infection. So they have started with the antibiotic.
But no, next that's day, why I was then, asking, was there any fever in presentation?
No, as a chief complaint is there, patient was not complained any fever or anything. Hello?
Any other questions?
Were there any signs of portal hypertension?
Yeah, portal hypertension means diastolic blood pressure was more for the patient. Except that no hypertension or anything.
This patient is systemic blood pressure.
Sorry.
What is documented here, 110 by 100, it's systemic blood pressure.
Yeah.
Portal blood pressure, was it high?
No. It was normal. Like 110 by 100, this is why means the blood carries through the liver to the heart. That thing will get blocked. So the heart, what it does is, it will increase its active, and it will increase, it will, 1 second, just a minute. So what heart will do is, it will increase, the pressure on the heart will increase. So thereby the BP will increase. That too only diastolic BP will increase.
Can you open a medication chart one? Last I didn't, I had a doubt.
Yeah. Sure.
Normal sign, how much it is given?
Sorry?
0.9% or 3% NS was given?
I didn't get that. I didn't mention.
I think they're not supposed to give any fluids for this patient.
Because it can aggravate arthritis again.
Then they will be planning to give diuretics, then why we should be on fluids again?
Sorry? They haven't given any diuretics.
No, they would plan to give, I think, for ascites. If already there is a lot of fluids in the body, then again, what is the point of giving TNS?
But that time, they haven't given the diuretics, no?
No, man. Why they are giving fluids? It will worsen no condition.
Worsen the condition, actually. Mm-hmm. There's no point of giving. So you're giving a patient on furosemide and if you're giving IV fluids again, what is the use? Like that.
Patient is already ascites, more fluid. Again, you're filling the body. Again, you're pushing the fluids. That worsens now.
Yes, sir.
Did they confirm the diagnosis only with serum albumin?
Sorry? Did they confirm the diagnosis only with the serum? Okay. No, yeah. First thing they have seen, like patient is, they have seen the chief complaints. Patient is having abdominal distensing. And one more thing, they have analyzed the ascites fluid in that the protein level is more. And yeah. Based upon those things, they have confirmed this diagnosis. Here we can clearly see that protein level in the serum is less.
Protein that can be in nephrotic syndrome also. They are also protein level.
Nephrotic syndrome. Nephrotic syndrome. Nephrotic syndrome, it will be less than. Sorry? Hello?
They will have to do liver biopsy, MRI, and all that to rule out. Only with the serum albumin, they will
have. As I told you, I have checked for 2 days, but those 2 days, they haven't done anything. Or they did only this thing, this test. What is that? Ascites fluid test. So, I have to put only that. And one more thing, someone asked me like it can be a nephrotic syndrome also. If it is less than 1.1 gram per deciliter only, we can tell it as a nephrotic syndrome or a bowel obstruction. But here in this case, it is more than 1.1 gram per deciliter. Any questions?
I have one question. Is there any effective on respiratory systems? Is there any effective on, in the respiratory systems? Means, is this affect the respiratory system?
Which system?
Respiratory.
Not able to hear. Respiratory system? No. It is completely not having any connection because it is completely depending on the liver.
No, because it's cause inflammatory of the abdomen, so the respiration becomes difficult.
It might cause only a bit of like hypertension, maybe. Since we have more diastolic blood pressure, we might see a bit. Hypertension, that's all.
This causes portal vein hypertension, actually.
Okay.
Or the veins, the hepatic veins are occluded.
Okay, thank you. Any other questions?
Okay, any other questions?
No, sir.
Okay. So, who is next presentation?